Look at all the crowd. It is teeming with people now. And that, as I've been saying repeatedly, is really what the Expo is all about. Everybody wants to come in. Everybody wants to get a piece of the action, get close to all of these beautiful cars and bikes. And it's nice to see that all the brands, even the premium brands, like the BMW Pavilion here, are allowing people to just come in, touch the cars, get into them. It's quite sensational. And there's hardly any place left to move. Now, last time in the 2014 edition is when we saw the change of venue, and it's also when the components and the products were split into two shows. So you have the ACMA overall taking care of the Pragati Maidan end of things when it comes to the Expo, and you have the SIAM, which is the Automobile Manufacturers Association, taking care of things here. What was happening at Pragati Maidan? There was plenty, I can assure you. Bala spent some time there. Here's the report.
The 2016 Auto Expo generated huge interest, not just for the new cars and bikes that were launched, but the components show had lots of attention despite being a different venue. The Components Show of 2016 Auto Expo saw participation from 1,500 companies and over a lakh visitors over 4 days.
Now, the big theme this year at the Components Show of the Auto Expo is the focus on innovation by Indian auto component players. And that's why ACMA has created this innovation pavilion, showcasing some of those products, especially in the component side, that are used in the cars that you drive.
The Made in India specialized innovations included lightweight fire-resistant insulation for engine room, composite parts, gear shifters, clutch booster, auto adjuster, drum brake for commercial vehicles, high-stress parabolic springs. Indian companies that were showcasing these included Sona Koyo, Lucas TVS and Brakes India. The auto components industry says Indian-built auto components are slowly but surely finding global recognition.
We're keeping our fingers crossed. I think we're going to start seeing some movement in the right direction. We'd obviously like it to be much faster, considering that we've had 3 years of difficult times. But I think it's moving in the right direction, and we're confident that we'll see better times in the years to come. But also, if you look at it from a medium and long-term perspective, we're launching the Automotive Mission Plan, and that has very ambitious growth targets of almost a 5x growth in the next 10 years. So most people are really positioning themselves to play for that game. So whether it happens in 10 years or 9 years or 11 years, I don't think is as important as the fact that we're going in that direction.
This year, the industry also highlighted the rising concerns on counterfeit products sold in the replacement market with a dedicated Asli Nakli Pavilion. One of the showstoppers this year was this futuristic-looking car from Sona Koyo Steering Systems named ELFA, showcasing an electronic power steering and electric axle that's been developed in-house by Sona Koyo. ELFA also boasts an electric power assist that uses an electric motor and torque sensor fitted inside to monitor the amount of steering input and deliver appropriate assistance. The company says the concept car indicates its focus on futuristic technologies from steering systems to driveline components.
Exciting times ahead because electronics is going to increase, automated driving assistance is going to increase. And therefore, new things are getting added. We being in the steering business, that has got a direct relationship with the automated driving. And the product, in fact, that we have displayed here is a step towards that. So this steering not only is a power-assisted electric power steering,
sure,
but it can be also remotely controlled from outside,
sure,
through a mobile app. So you can actually steer the vehicle the way you want, sitting outside.
The show also saw some large foreign participation with 6 overseas delegations and 8 dedicated international pavilions. The Components Show also had interesting consumer technologies like car cabin air purifiers, new age car wash techniques, premium seat covers and even off-roading accessories. So you could say there was something for everyone. The auto components industry is quite pleased with the strong response seen this year.